Hello, my dear students. I am your science teacher, Mrs. Pramila Fernandez. I hope you are fine and safe at home. Today, we are going to learn the first chapter of Science 2, that is classification of plants. Students, you have already studied in the 8th standard the kingdom Monera, Protista and Fungi of the five kingdom classification system proposed by the scientist Robert Whittaker for the study of living organisms. This year we will learn more about kingdom Plantae. Before we start the lesson, we will just recall some terms which will be helpful to study the plants by observing the flowchart. The living organisms are divided mainly into two categories, prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms. Prokaryotic means the organisms having false nucleus, that is, there is no well-defined nucleus. Eukaryotic means the organisms with well-defined nucleus with nuclear membrane. If we go further, the eukaryotic organisms are divided into unicellular and multicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms are the organisms which having single cell, example amoeba. Multicellular organisms are with many cells, example human beings. Again, multicellular organisms are divided into two variety, that is with cell wall and without cell wall. Students, you must be remembering this is the main characteristic to differentiate the plant cell and animal cell. Now we'll go further. Organisms with cell wall are again divided into two categories, autotrophs and heterotrophs. Auto means own. Therefore, autotrophs means preparing their own food. Plants come under this category because they have a green pigment called chlorophyll which helps in photosynthesis, that is preparation of food. Heterotrophs means depending on others for their food. Fungi are coming in this category. Students, we human beings are also heterotrophs, but we come under the category organisms without cell wall. Now, you can define the plant by looking at this chart. That is, plants are autotrophs with cell wall. They are multicellular with eukaryotic cells. The group of autotrophic living organisms having eukaryotic cells with cell wall is the group of plants. Basis for classification. Criteria for classification of plants. The first criteria for classification plant is presence or absence of organs. Root, stem, leaf, flower, etc. are the different organs the plant is having. On these organs present or absence, the plants are classified. The second criteria is the presence or absence of separate conducting tissues. Plants are having two conducting tissues, xylem, which conducts water, phloem, which conducts the food. Presence or absence of these conducting tissue is the another criteria. Presence or absence of seeds is the third criteria. If seeds are present, then whether they are enclosed in the fruit or not. If the seeds are enclosed in the fruit or not is the next criteria for classification of plants. The fourth criteria is number of cotyledons in the seeds. Seeds have cotyledons. the number of cotyledons are taken to consider to classify the plants. The higher level of plants are again classified into two subkingdom, cryptogams and phanerogams, depending on absence or presence of flowers, fruits and seeds. Students, about cryptogams and phanerogams, we will study in the next class.